the Lord. Did we pray for everybody? Yes, Steve. Steve, we're right back. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Somebody have this one out. Jesus. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. You may have your seats, everybody. Hallelujah. Somebody say Jesus. Come on. Jesus. 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 Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God is good. Amen. Well, it's a good thing to be in the house of God this morning, everybody. So nice to see everybody. Everybody look well dressed on the outside. I pray that you're also dressed on the inside. Amen. You're also clothed with the Holy Spirit. Praise the Lord. You know, we clothe ourselves on the inside, right? By prayer, by looking up to Jesus, by acknowledging Him, by making sure somebody help out. She got up like she drunk there. Now, watch who got up. Oh, God, oh, God. Somebody come. Somebody come, please. Manos. I seen somebody come, the men them watching. So you see Joash and she going on anywhere. Oh Lord. That is travel Sunday morning. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. God is a good God. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Where's Shania? Shania? Come. I can't make out Shania these days and something strange about she. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Well, this morning we serve a good God, and it's so wonderful and it's so great to be in church this morning. Amen. So, what's the name of the game? Well, it's no game. With Jesus, serious business. Amen. Amen. With Jesus, it's serious business. Amen. Come back. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So, I'm going to ask all the youths to come to the front, please. All the youths come. Steve will join in with Andrew. Steve will join in with Andrew there. You know, that boy is in my dad and board there. Day before night, I was in my bedroom. And I tell the prophet this. I need a next song. How do you call it? The person on the board. Song engineer. Just I was telling you, I need a next song engineer. I tell you 5 times. And remember yesterday, Andrew walked in and he said, his job is song engineering. Come on, I'll give God a big clap. Hallelujah. Because sometimes it's good to have more than one, amen? You don't know what could happen. So it's good to have more than one person. Amen. A church function as one person. A church function as a body. We are the body of Christ. Amen. So we're going to do a beautiful song this morning. Can I think of the goodness of Jesus? It's an Eastern Young version. All that you have done for me. We're going to pipe it up. Right? Everything is on the go. Okay, we're getting hype up. Well, this morning we have Rahul, everybody. We have Rahul Joseph. As I welcome Indian in the church, those who don't know, as the man called Rahul Joseph. Amen? He just handled all the abuse. On a Saturday, we really deserve a ball. All deserve a ball. Raise your hand.
Who's
having
a ball? On
Saturday. Wow, yeah. Really awesome, really awesome. Let's go. Let's go, Steve. Let's go. Come on. Yeah. Come on. Little lyrics. Take it up. Yeah. Yeah. Look at all of
us. In the goodness of Jesus, I'm only inside. I will roll, rock and roll, rock and roll. Jesus gave
Style man, come on, all the way in Africa. No. Amen. We're gonna do OJ. Ladies and gentlemen, who takes some for those who don't wait?
Ladies and gentlemen, as they say, good things come to those who wait. The man himself is ready. Are you ready for OJ?
Yeah!
Yeah!
Sunday morning and we're praising God. Amen?
Amen.
It's a delighting thing to praise God. We're going to do search all over. No one like Jesus. Amen. We're going to do a beautiful worship song. And everybody, from your heart, from your soul, come on. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Yeah, come on. Come on. Praise the Lord. Climbing to the highest mountain.
Climbing to the highest mountain. Looked all around and find a valley.
Hey, come on.
The deep blue sea, confined and confined, to the creature of your mercy. Nobody greater
than Jesus. Hey, nobody greater than Jesus. Come on.
So shallow, couldn't find nobody. Had a high and low. Nobody great, nobody greater, no, nobody greater than you. So sorrow, couldn't find nobody. At a high and low, still couldn't find nobody. Nobody greater, nobody great, nobody greater than you. Nobody can heal like you can.
Come on, everybody.
Almost holy one,
you are the great I am. Come on, tell them this morning.
Awesome and
push them
off. You carry me down on redemption's plan. You carry me down on redemption's plan.
Search all over, all over. You can't find nobody like Jesus. He's the only one that can address our problem. He's the only one that can help us.
Nobody greater than Jesus.
Nobody, absolutely nobody.
Search all over.
Search all over.
Find
nobody. Everybody, come on. Make a joyful noise. Everybody give each other a hug. It's so beautiful. Come on, just hug each other. God is so good. The Bible says if you don't love, he is nothing. Amen? So we're going to thank God. Like him, come on, keep God, please. Thank you very much. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. This morning we have an preacher all the way from right in the kitchen upstairs. Right in the kitchen upstairs. My favorite place for our food and all that. But this morning here is spiritual food. And she's right here. Amen. So welcome everybody. First of all, we must say we love you very much. Amen. I don't think I've seen any new faces. Well, all faces new, but what I mean, like, first time people now. Andrew's the only new face here, boy. Praise the Lord. God is good, everybody. Come on, give Jesus a clap, man. Come on, come on, come on. Hallelujah. Amen. Make a smile, make a smile. Like Mary, thing you put in your head. That's yours? That little children thinking of in your head. That butterfly. Praise the Lord. God is good. Okay, though. Well, we'll have prophetess right away.
Hallelujah. good morning, church. It's a good morning, amen. And I sure God is glad of our worship this morning. He is proud of his children. And I know he loves each one of us dearly, amen. Because that is our Father. Turn to your Bibles to John chapter 4. John chapter 4. A true story. Everything that the Bible is contained is truth. Amen. The Holy Spirit inspired great men to write the Bible so that we can get teaching, knowledge, wisdom from the Bible to live our life, our everyday life. Amen. And this true story is about Jesus, his disciples, and the Pharisees. You see, Jesus was here with his disciples. And his disciples was baptizing people. But news came to the Pharisees that it was Jesus who was gaining. But the Pharisees did not know that it was his disciples that was baptizing the people. So when the Lord, which is Jesus, heard of this, he left and he went to Galilee. If you read from the beginning, when you have time, you can read the whole true story. Amen. Jesus would leave and he went to Galilee. And when he went to Galilee, he went through Samaria. He came to a town called Sychar. I hope I pronounced that right. It sounds like an Indian name, eh? Sychar.
Maybe I pronounce it well.
Now, when he came to that place is where Jacob had his well. And you know that Jacob was a man worthy of God. Amen. He was a man that did great miracle in the Old Testament, if everyone knew the Bible. And here, Jacob had as well. And Jesus was tired. You may ask, but he's the Son of God. He was tired. Now he came on earth as a man, walking in flesh. But he was the Son of God. He did a lot of miracles. He spent all his time, day and night, ministering to his people. But here he was tired, so he wanted rest. Amen. Most of us, or all of us, need rest sometime in our life. We work all day. We go to school. We do our chores. And we need rest. That's why the Lord made the night, so that our body can be rested. Amen. So here Jesus wanted a rest. So he went by Jacob's well to take a rest. There he sat down, the Bible said. The Bible said in chapter 6, it was about the sixth hour. The sixth hour, it was about noon. And that time, you know that the sun is very hot. Amen. It's the time of the day that people feel tired. So they need a little relaxation. So here Jesus was by the well about the sixth hour, which was noon. Chapter 7 said that when a Samaritan woman came to draw water, Jesus said to her, "Will you give me a drink?" Verse 8 said, his disciples have gone into the town to buy food. So here it is that Jesus was alone. He was hungry. Amen. The disciple I sure was hungry. And the woman came to throw water at noon time. Wow. You know, normally people will not go to a well noon time because the sun was hot. They will go early morning to draw water, or they will go late in the evening when the sun was down. But this Samaritan woman chose midday. So here she was by the well. Verse 9 said, the Samaritan woman said to him, you are a Jew, I am a Samaritan woman. How can you ask me for a drink? For Jews do not associate with Samaritan. Wow. So there was division. At that time, there was division between Jew and Samaritan people. They do not see eye to eye. There was a division. And here Jesus was a Jew. And he came and he asked a Samaritan woman for water. How could that be? Amen. I sure at that point, maybe the woman could have get angry with Jesus. Why are you asking me? We do not associate. Your people do not like my people, and my people do not.